Hi friends, this is Krish Thiyarpan Naxal, and today I'm going to give you one more reason why you should not book flats in under construction projects. The reason is because you cannot keep your promise to yourself, let alone keep your promise to others. Let me explain. I have found that whenever I say I'm going to come back in half an hour or 1 hour, I'm usually wrong. That 1 hour becomes 3 hours. If I say I'm going to complete a task in 10 minutes or 15 minutes, if I say I'm going to send a Word file or an Excel file to someone in 15 minutes, I'm usually wrong. It becomes half an hour or 1 hour. It is quite rare that I'm able to finish as per commitment. This is a fact. Now let's talk about financial commitments. When you take a flat, an under construction flat, and you buy it, sitting at the sales office of the builder with time pressure, and the builder wants you to swipe your card, maybe you have your wife or your father with you, and you are thinking how you're going to clear all those payments. And you say, well, this much money will come from our fixed deposits, and this much money will come from saving the mutual funds, selling the mutual funds, and this much money will come from selling that flat which we have got in Hyderabad, and this much money will come from loan, and we will have to take a loan of this much amount. When you make all these projections, they are usually wrong. They are usually optimistic. They are too optimistic. This is my understanding based on my own actions in the past. We are always optimistic, over-optimistic on what we are able to do. If I am capable of getting a 40 lakh rupees loan, I will tell myself I am capable of getting a 60 or a 70 lakh rupees loan. If I am capable of selling a house in 6 months or 1 year, I am going to try and say that I am actually going to sell that house in 3 months. This is how we make projections habitually. And when we go wrong and we have to make payment for an under construction flat, the builder starts to penalize us. He starts charging penal interest. He starts making you pay for that mistake which you made in the sales office under pressure. So, sum total, we are extremely poor predictors of our own capacity to pay and our own actions. Now, there is one more angle that I want to want you guys to think about. We are also very short of attention span. We have very little attention span because we have a lot of things going on in our lives. We have so many things to look at work-wise. We have so many commitments which keep changing. We have so many pressures coming from our family. And we waste so much of our time looking at Instagram, Facebook, YouTube videos, YouTube shorts, all kinds of things, WhatsApp forwards. We have so many demands on our time that we are actually extremely distracted people. We are not ourselves. We are distracted. We are sleepless. We have serious attention deficit issues. This is a problem when we have to meet a very tight payment schedule. Because you have to go to a bank on a particular day and break those FDs. You have to send out letters of request or send out emails to break those mutual funds which you have got, sell them, cash them. You have tough decisions to make when you have to sell your house. You have tough decisions to make when you have to take a loan. Things don't go according to your schedule, and you yourself find it very difficult to go according to your own schedule. You are incapable. We all are incapable of following the tight schedules which we think we are capable of following. For payments, for all kinds of commitments. So when we swipe our card at the builder's office for a flat, you know what? We usually overcommit. We overcommit in terms of time, especially. We may also overcommit in terms of amounts. We may think that we are capable of buying the 3 BHK or 4 BHK when we are not. We are only capable of buying a 2 BHK properly and comfortably. We may think that our salary will increase next year, and so we will be finding it more easy to pay those EMIs. But you know what? Life doesn't always play the game the way we want to play it. You may find that you are losing your job, or you may find that your business is going down and you are not able to keep up with the pressure of paying EMIs. Life has a way of taking you by surprise. You have to expect it. You have to expect the unexpected. You have to leave buffer scope for all sorts of surprises. You may say, I would have paid this if something had not happened. Yes, but that something did happen. And that is the nature of life. Things happen. They surprise you. You may say, oh well, I have thought of everything. No, you haven't. Something will surprise you. And that is one more reason why you should not enter into long-term commitments of 20 years and 30 years, like massive home loans, which take up a very large chunk of your salary or any other income. You should not do these things to yourself for a non-existing asset. Do it if you want, if the asset actually exists. Does the flat actually exist? Is the flat there? Could you see it? If you did, then okay, maybe you can take a risk. Maybe. After calculating and after consideration, not on the same day, not in the sales office, do not swipe your damn card in the sales office. You may have a credit limit of 1 lakh. You may have a credit limit of 5 lakhs. You may be proud of your credit limit. Be careful. That pride will make you slip up and fall down on your damn nose. It'll hurt you. It'll hurt you really bad. And the builder's policy is not to be gentle with you, is not to be understanding with you. That is not how builders operate. The builder's policy is, once you have swiped a token, especially a large token, paid a booking amount, they're going to screw you for every single mistake that you make in predicting your own actions. Every single mistake that you made in predicting your credit worthiness, in predicting and projecting your asset position, in projecting your liquidity position, in projecting how much your family will or will not cooperate. Remember one thing. You may think that your dad or your uncle will lend you money when you need it. That's an assumption. They may not. You may say, oh, they will bail me out. They may not. There may be terms and conditions. They may say they have their own problems. So don't take things for granted. When you swipe on the first day at the sales office of a builder under time pressure because of Diwali offer and Christmas offer, you are making the mistake. You are definitely making the mistake. I'm going to say this with an emphasis. I'm not saying you will possibly make a mistake. I'm saying you will probably make a mistake, or you will even definitely make a mistake. if you are swiping on that day out of impulse. Don't swipe. Don't swipe. Go back. Go back home. Take a pen and paper. Do some calculation. Not based on your ideas, based on actual facts. Check your bank books. How much money do you have? Check your FD certificates. Check your mutual funds. How much do you have? How many do you have? Which ones do you want to sell? Which ones can't you afford to sell? Which ones will cause you a loss if you sell now? Think about all these things. Go back to the sales office if you're really, really keen. I'm not recommending this. But if you're really, really keen on that deal which they offered you, if you're really sold, and assuming for a moment you really got a good deal, which as I said, is not very likely. But if you're damn convinced that you got a good deal, then please go back to that builder's office after 3 or 4 days. Give it a cooling off period. If they say, no, no, sir, the deal is off, don't worry. There are many more deals that are being born every day. Don't let them scare you. Don't let them cow you down with this thing of, today you walk out of our office, tomorrow we will not give you this offer. That's a lie. They always want your money. They will want your money today. They will want your money tomorrow. They will want your money if you come back next week. And if you say, this was the offer you gave me, you will bloody well give me the offer or else they will give it to you. Be confident, but be very, very careful, because as I said, we are extremely poor predictors of our own actions, of our own capacity, of our own finances, our own ability to fulfill our promises. Please be aware of your own weakness. Also remember that if you are accepting a very tight schedule, you may fail to give it the kind of time and energy and attention it requires, and you will fail simply because of attention deficit, because you're too tired, because you're too tired to send out an email, because you're too tired to go to the bank, because you're too tired, too busy, too occupied with other things in life. So please do not accept tight schedules for payment. Please don't assume that if someone owes you money, he is going to give you that money promptly, and therefore you will have it when the time comes to pay the builder. That may not happen. Please be very, very conservative. Otherwise, builders will put you to a loss. I am your friend, Krish the Urban Naxal. Jai Hind. Jai Maharashtra. Jai Jawan. Jai Kisan.